how to install the add-on. First, I remove any unnecessary elements from the scene. Then I go to the Edit menu and click on Preferences. After that, I click on Install from Disk and select the Mixamo add-on. As you can see, it appears in the list, already selected. The add-on is now successfully installed. So where is it located? When you press the N key on your keyboard, you'll see the Mixamo Tools tab appear on the right side of the viewport. How to use the add-on. I have previously downloaded 5 different animations from Mixamo. I start by importing these into the scene. Again, I remove anything unnecessary from the scene. Then I go to File, Import, FBX, and I import the 5 animations I just mentioned. Now all 6 animations are in the scene. As you can see, each one is playing its own movement. Now we'll assign all of these movements to a single armature. For the best results, I usually assign all actions to the first armature. When I click Load Action, the add-on lists all available animations in the scene. Second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. As you may have noticed, the first animation appears at the bottom of the list. I move it to the top using the arrow buttons on the right. Now that it's at the top, we no longer need the other armatures, so we can delete them. We'll assign all the animations to the single armature in the scene. I click Confirm Order, and then hit the Send button. What happens next? In the Non-Linear Animation, NLA, editor, you'll see all the animations listed in order as separate strips. And that's it. This is how simple the add-on works. As you play the animation, the actions are triggered one after the other. This is the core functionality of the add-on. Let's play it again. As you can see, the animations are sequenced smoothly. Baking the animation. To bake the animation into a single action, all you need to do is select the armature and click Bake Action. Once clicked, a new action will be generated, containing all animations combined into one. As shown, I select the armature, click Bake Action, and now a new action appears in the list. All animations have been merged into a single, unified action. At this point, we no longer need the other actions and can safely delete them. Now our animation is ready as a single baked action. You can also export it at this stage if needed. Stabilizing root motion. Finally, I will show you the stabilize root feature. To do this, I click on the action in the timeline. Then I press the tab key. After this, I press the stability root button. This will move the animation in place, meaning the root movement will be locked. As you can see, the animation now plays while the character stays in position. Defining actions and managing animations in Mixamo add-on. As you can see, all the animations are still loaded. I deleted the idle animation from the scene because it was too long. But since it was previously added, it still shows up in the list. When I click Load Action, it's still listed, although the armature has already been removed. So only the action remains. At this point, the list may look cluttered. To organize it, we can rename the actions directly from the scene collection by double-clicking each armature. For instance, I rename one to Walk. Then, when I click Load Action again, the name is updated. I continue this for the rest, making it easier to visually identify each animation. Once all armatures are properly renamed, you'll notice the deleted one, Idle, still appears at the bottom. Since we don't want to include it, simply disable the checkbox next to it. This is a quick and clean solution. On the right, you can see frame counts, showing the duration of each action. You can also preview these in the lower left of the screen or within the add-on itself. For example, I want the walk animation to play longer, say 93 frames instead of 31, so I set its repeat count to 3. Now, when we run the animation, it will play walk 3 times before moving to the next action. I remove all the other unnecessary armatures and assign the actions to just one. Let's see how it works. I open the non-linear animation panel. Right now, only the walk action appears because it's currently active. I click Confirm Order, then Send. As shown, the 3 repeated walk actions are listed, followed by Run, and then Run and Jump, all smoothly sequenced. Everything looks fine from the side view as well. Bake and stabilize. Next, I click Bake action with the armature selected. It merges all animations into a single action. After baking, I press Tab and then click Stabilize Root. The entire animation now plays in place with no global movement. Everything stays centered. Looping a single animation with Mixamo. Sometimes we want to loop just one animation, like a walk cycle. This add-on makes it easy. I imported the walk animation, renamed it, and clicked Load Action. It appeared in the list. By default, it plays once, but I can double-click and type 10 to repeat it 10 times. For repeated animations, set overlap frames to 1 instead of the default 3. This ensures smoother transitions. After setting it, I click Confirm Order and then Send. In the NLA editor, all 10 loops are now visible and flow smoothly. To combine them into a single action, I select the armature, press Bake action, and then click Stabilize Root. Now the animation plays in place, and it's ready to export. Repeating and sequencing animations. Sometimes we want to repeat certain animations and mix them with others. Let me show how. Say I want to play walk twice, run 3 times, and the final animation once. I clean up the scene by deleting unused armatures and renaming the remaining actions. One, two, three, and so on. Then I click Confirm Order, then Send, and check the timeline. It plays Walk twice, Run three times, and then the final animation, just as planned. Fixing harsh transitions. Let's talk about animation transitions. From the front view, things look fine. But from the side, you might notice harsh jumps between repeated identical animations like walk or run. The solution is simple. Set overlap frame to 0 for repeated actions. Set blend in to 1. This creates a seamless transition. For different animations, try blend in values like 3, 7, or 8, depending on the motion. In this example, all run animations are identical. I set blend frames to 0 and blend in to 1, placing them with 3 frame overlaps. The result is a much smoother transition. These tweaks are essential for achieving fluid motion between clips. When done right, everything flows naturally.